I'm Swift and His Electric Runabout, or The Speediest Car on the Road by Victor Appleton. Introduction. Three very successful series of stories aimed at children and teens were created by a man who had a book packaging house and didn't want to cause confusion. So none of the stories ever had his name on them. Instead, Edward Stratemeyer hired several writers and provided him with story ideas that were then published under the pseudonym Victor Appleton. They were tales of the adventures of a teenager named Tom Swift. He was portrayed as a youngster who didn't have a lot of formal education, but was inventive and science-minded. This led to more than 100 volumes with a variety of broad-ranging adventures and creative ideas placing emphasis on invention, science, and technology. Stratemeyer later came up with successful stories about the Hardy Boys and Nancy Drew. It is said the fertile Stratemeyer imagination often found him jotting down a short page of notes involving plots and assigning a stable of about a half dozen writers to sort of fill in the blanks. The Hardy Boys were amateur detectives, often able to solve various cases when solutions eluded grown-up professionals. First appearance of the female counterpart Nancy Drew series first appeared in 1930 and ran for nearly three quarters of a century. We listen now to Tom Swift with one of his top inventions. Chapter 1, Tom Hopes for a Prize. "Father," exclaimed Tom Swift, looking up from the paper he was reading, "I think I can win that prize."
"What prize is that?"
inquired the aged inventor, gazing away from a drawing of a complicated machine and pausing in his task of making some intricate calculations.
"You don't mean to say, Tom, that you're going to have a try for a government prize for a submarine after all?"
"No, not a submarine prize, Dad." And the youth laughed. "Though our advance would take the prize away from almost any other underwater boat, I imagine. No, it's another prize I'm thinking about."
"What do you mean?"
"Well, I see by this paper that the Touring Club of America has offered $3,000 for the speediest electric car. The tests are to come off this fall on a new and specially built track on Long Island, and it's to be an endurance contest for 24 hours or a race for distance. They haven't decided yet, but I'm going to have a try for it, Dad. And besides winning the prize, I think I'll take Andy Foger down a peg."
"What's Andy been doing now?"
"Oh, nothing more than usual. He's always mean and looking for a chance to make trouble for me, but I didn't refer to anything special. He has a new auto, you know, and he boasts that it's the fastest one in this country. I'll show him that it isn't, for I'm going to win this prize with the speediest car on the road."
"But, Tom, you haven't any automobile, you know."
And Mr. Swift looked anxiously at his son, who was smiling confidently.
"You can't be going to make your motorcycle into an auto, are you?"
"No, Dad."
"Then how are you going to take part in the prize contest? Besides, electric cars, as far as I know, aren't specially speedy."
"I know it. And one reason why this club has arranged the contest is to improve the quality of electric automobiles. I'm going to build an electric runabout, Dad."
"An electric runabout? But it will have to be operated with a storage battery, Tom. And you haven't..."
"I guess you're going to say I haven't any storage battery, Dad," interrupted Mr. Swift's son.
"Well, I haven't yet, but I'm going to have one. I've been working on..."
"Oh, ho, ho!" exclaimed the aged inventor with a laugh. "So that's what you've been tinkering over these last few weeks, huh, Tom?
I suspected it was some new invention, but I didn't suppose it was that. Well, how are you coming on it?"
"Pretty good, I think. I've got a new idea for a battery, and I made an experimental one. I gave it some pretty severe tests, and it worked fine."
"You haven't tried it out in a car yet over rough roads and under severe conditions, have you?"
"No, I haven't had a chance. In fact, when I invented the battery, I had no idea of using it on a car. I thought it might answer for commercial purposes or for storing a current generated by windmills.
but when I read that account in the papers of the touring club offering a prize for the best electric car, it occurred to me that I might put my battery into an auto and win. Remarked Mr. Swift musingly. I don't take much stock in electric autos, Tom. Gasoline seems to be the best, or perhaps steam generated by gasoline. I'm afraid you'll be disappointed. All the electric runabouts I ever saw, while they were very nice cars, didn't seem able to go very fast or very far. That's true, but it's because they didn't have the right kind of a battery. You know, an electric locomotive can make a pretty good speed, Dad. Over 100 miles an hour in tests. Yes, but they don't run by storage batteries. They have a third rail and powerful motors. And Mr. Swift looked quizzically at his son. He loved to argue with him, for he said it made Tom think, and often the two would thus thresh out some knotty point of an invention to the interests of both. Of course, Dad, there is a good deal of theory in what I'm thinking of, the lad admitted, but it does seem to me that if you put the right kind of a battery into an automobile, it could scoot along pretty lively. Look what speed a trolley car can make. Yes, Tom, but there again, they get their power from an overhead wire. Some of them don't. There's a new storage battery being invented by a New Jersey man, which does as well as the third rail or the overhead wire.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.